Those, to me, are the most valuable pair of glasses Elvis ever owned. Because they're one of a kind.
Follow the Dream, yeah.
Follow the Dream.
One of my favorite Elvis movies. Yeah. I like that movie because of the location.
Yep.
Yeah, man, that's cool. And there he is wearing the...
He bought them off of a fan. He didn't have any. He needed some. They gave a fan $100. And the fan gave them to him, and they're cool.
You know? No, so let me ask you this. How much do you wear those?
Never. I don't touch them. Nope.
That is great, man.
So this is all the jewelry. And this TCB's is, that's mine. I just bought that from Lowell Hayes like 12, 13 years ago.
Oh, that's your TCB. Yeah. But this is Tish? This
that's was Tish? Yeah, that's Tish Emily's. Yep. Nice lady.
Yeah, I love Tish. I'll have to, before I leave, I'll take a picture of it and text her.
Like, check yeah, out, she text, knows
check
I
Check this
have
out, it. Tish. I just saw your TLC.
Yeah, there you go.
See what she tells me. That is cool, man. Teal, tender, love, and care. And this was Elvis, one of his TCBs, right? Is that what you said?
Yeah, that's the one he gave to Dr. Ghanem.
This was the one he gave to Ghanem, okay.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. And that's all the TCBs I have.
Yeah, Larry Moss, when I saw his stuff there, he brought a TCB and gave it to me to put on, and I couldn't figure out how to put it on. Because, you know, it just has the neck.
Yeah, you just flip it over
here. You just flip it over. It took me a while because I had never, you know.
That's one way you tell a fake one from a real one. Yeah. There's people that don't know.
Yeah.
It's a heavier chain and there's no clasp. It just goes over your neck.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't see the bracelet. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a watch holder, actually. The watch isn't in it. But
a watch holder.
You can put a...
Oh, right here.
You can put a watch in there. Yeah. Pretty cool stuff.
Well, you have some amazing stuff, the Elvis Presley Mexican ring.
Yeah, man, have you, I don't know if you figured it out, but I live in a museum.
I love the museum, too.
Well, a cave, I guess.
Yeah, it's the Bat Cave, the Glen Cave.
Now, what we got in here? We've got, in here, we've got magazines. So these are old magazines from the 50s, you know, Hepcat, and you know, you name it. And I actually found a photo of Elvis reading one of his own magazines.
Oh, yeah, which one?
That he's one. Reading that right
yeah,
there.
That yeah, that one right there. Yeah. Hey, and he's at Jim's Barber Shop on Main Street in that picture.
No kidding.
Yep.
See, I didn't know that.
The building, one, man. The building is still there.
That's cool.
So we need to get inside that building, man. And
so these are all just magazines, man. It's yeah. Like
and perfect. That's his hero, of course.
James yeah, Jimmy. Now over here, I don't have a lot for his ranch. But we got a horseshoe from Circle G. We have an original. Now here's another autograph. I don't know how many that makes.
I think we're at 19. Yeah.
Elvis Presley. He bought one. This is for one of the mobile homes. And then here's some receipts for horse feed.
Westinghouse.
And there's his picture of his daddy. And
there's Vernon at the Circle G.
Yeah. So this is all Circle G stuff.
So how much did he pay?
For the
grand.
Mobile home?
10 grand.
What was that?
10,998.
You got better eyes than me. 10,000. That was a lot of money back then for
1967.
A mobile home. Yeah. Now, this was not his and Priscilla's, I don't think. I could be wrong.
Yeah.
But I don't think this was his and Priscilla's.
So, Priscilla needs a visit. Visitor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd let her in.
Yeah, I think so. I think so. We'll let Priscilla in.
Yeah. So, this is the main room.
Oh, my goodness. Wow, here we go, guys. What is in here?
So this is all...
Don't cheat now, y'all. Don't be looking around.
This is all done chronological order. So in the backdrop of everything are his movies. So these are original movie posters that came from the theaters. Original soundtrack, original movie script.
Yeah.
Some scripts, I don't have all the scripts. I have most of them. There's only one movie that didn't have a soundtrack, and that was The Trouble with Girls, because it was a low budget. But so it starts and goes clockwise. Starts here, it goes clockwise, and it ends right there.
And it ends with the last with Change of Habit. Yep. This is great. Now, I love this piece right here. So this would have been that movie at the theaters back then, right?
Yeah, this was at the movie theaters.
How hard was it you to find this?
Oh, man.
That was hard, right?
Years.
And it's in really good condition.
Yeah, it's in great shape.
You know?
And again, like I said, I don't do records, but I do have the record soundtrack
now behind there
for each one. Yeah.
Check that out, guys.
You get the right angle. Yeah. That's the tricky thing, the way we have everything displayed, trying to conserve space. You got to get the right angle.
Got to get the right angle of everything.
So from this angle over here, you can see the contract he signed to do Love Me Tender. That's the signature page.
That is the Love Me Tender contract. Okay. Check this out.
Elvis Presley, January 21st, 1950. Does that say 55? Can't read it.
EP.
So, nice photo.
January 31st, 1956.
56, there you go.
So that's number 20, Glenn.
And we got, so before the film came out, you know, they made the film, they had copies of the film, but before it premiered, they loaned a film reel to Elvis. But he had to sign this release stating that he would not show it to anyone. And of course, he signed it. It's original. That's an original document. And I forget where we're at. 21?
21. That is number 21.
So there's the original film script. You notice it's the Reno Brothers, originally titled Reno Brothers. Script is 1953. What's really cool is, yeah, I go thumbing through all these scripts.
You
never know what you're going to find in them. I'll tell you about one that's real interesting down the road here. But this one, I found some editor notes. The editor wrote in there, "Great script, but needs more lust and booty." So I don't think he accomplished that with that movie, but anyway.
That's amazing, man. Hey, there were men back then. So I love it.
Just didn't think they talked that way in 53, but...
Well, we have an idea of I Love Lucy and the Andy Griffith Show, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. There's a shoe tag from the movie that they had on Elvis's shoes that he wore, just tagging them. And then right up from that is your original acetate for Love Me Tender. You know, people always ask me, you know, is that the one they made press copies off of and sold? It's like, I honestly don't know. I don't know if that's the one they accepted as the final take or
right.
not.
But we know it is.
Probably not, because I have it. Otherwise, it'd be somewhere else. But how many takes did he make? Elvis was known for not doing very many takes because he was that good. So, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if he, you know, did 15 or less in most songs. So, but it's still an original acetate, and the fact is that was in the room with Elvis when Elvis was singing the song.
That was in the room, guys, no doubt.
So that's only acetates. You know, you'll see acetates throughout the collection. So here we got you have three signatures from Elvis involving Loving You movie. Three in a row there.
25
sounds good to me. Close enough. Don't have that script yet, but the poster's in great shape.
But you're working on it.
Oh, I'm always working on it. Now, so we were talking about earlier the most valuable record, Elvis Presley record in the world.
Right.
And that's right there.
Where?
The Treat Me Nice record.
Vince Everett.
Yeah, it's not by Elvis. It's by Vince Everett, Laurel Record Company.
Yeah.
Right? So this was a prop in the movie.
Yeah.
He goes into the record store and he's thumbing through.
Yeah, I remember that.
And so one of the extras in the movie stole it.
Thank you, whoever you are.
And her name is Sylvia.
Sylvia.
And Sylvia got it autographed to her. And there it is.
26.
I call that a Smithsonian.
That's epic, Smithsonian. Epic. EPIC capitalization, Glenn.
Number one record in the Jerry Osborne Book of Record Values for Elvis Presley.
Yeah, I don't even want to ask you how much that one is worth.
That you know, if I had to guess, that piece is probably worth around $20,000-$25,000. You know, that's my guess. This, shoes are fake, okay. If you want to use that word.
They're a prop.
There you go. I hate to be fake. Sweater is a knockoff from Hal Lansky.
Okay. So that's, you bought this at Lansky's.
Yes. Sweaters from Lansky. The pants, which are a dark, dark blue. You know, the movie Jailhouse Rock's black and white, so yep. We always thought they were black pants. Uh-huh. These are the pants he wore in Jailhouse Rock, where he films the scene at the swimming pool, You're So Square.
Elvis is wearing those pants in that famous scene right there, guys, and they are navy blue. Correct?
Yeah. That's it. And on the back wall, you can see they have him wearing that. That's what they did in the movie so they can make sure they get the right stuff tagged.
Wardrobe.
Wardrobe stuff.
Yeah, I have to do it all the time. Make sure that you're wearing the same thing, you know, because in this scene, they mess up. Scotty's sunglasses.
That's right, sunglasses.
It was this actual scene.
Crazy, huh?
Man, Elvis, guys, and look there. There's his name, Elvis Presley.
See, the problem was they were too busy watching Elvis.
Exactly, not caring, whatever. And that is cool. Cool, man.
So we got the script. That's a vault copy, which is cool. And that is an acetate for Jailhouse Rock. The song Jailhouse Rock. Yeah. So that's, we're up to the third movie. I don't know how everybody else feels, but my favorite movies
King
are
Creo. Jailhouse Rock, King Creo, and Lonely Tender.
The movies in the '50s were the best.
Yeah. After he goes to the army, man, he changes.
Now, man, I got that poster, and it was in three pieces.
No way! I can't even tell.
I spent personally. He had no hand. The right hand wasn't one.
Okay.
So. I made the hand. So it's I spent about 40 hours putting that poster, that standee together.
Good work.
And it's actually standing on its own.
That is standing on its own right there, huh?
Yep. That sucker's rare.
I bet that is rare. I was going to ask you. Check that out.
We've got the script up there. We've got the poster, which has had some work done to it.
That's Elvis's King Creo script.
Yep. And then there's the sweater and shirt he wore in King Creole and a picture of him wearing it.
There in the French Quarter. So that is both the sweater and that shirt from that scene when he, I believe the scene when somebody's chasing him. I believe he's wearing this.
Man, don't give me the, I can't remember. It's been a while.
Yeah, me and Billy, we just came back from New Orleans.
Oh, that's cool.
Filming these locations where the scene took place. Incredible. Incredible, man. King Creo. Yeah, epic. Elvis in the 50s, man. That was real Elvis. That was...
This next piece, this is a lot of people's favorite simply because, you know, the Army. Mm-hmm. So everything you see is Elvis. It was his. It's what he wore. Starting at the shoes. Those were his shoes, his socks, his pants, his jacket, tie, shirt, and hat. That's all Elvis.
How long have you had this piece?
I've had that piece for, 6 years?
Yeah.
Six, seven years?
Yeah, Glenn, you only see this at Graceland. Yeah, you know, something like that. So
I don't even know if they have one.
I don't even know if they have that.
So this is the complete uniform he gave to the director of G.I. Blues, Norman Trog. And it came from his estate. So that's a pretty cool piece to me. And then, of course, you got the Elvis Barbie doll wearing the same uniform in the back. Back behind that, and I found a picture of Elvis wearing the uniform. Part of the medal is missing on his pocket, but other than that, it's pretty solid.
Yeah, he's wearing that one right there in that picture, isn't he?
Yep. Now you see Elvis below that. He's got his stripes on, and he's sewing something.
Yeah, this one.
So that is Elvis's Army issued sewing kit. It's got his name, his social, everything stamped in the box of that sewing kit. and I found a picture of him what are the odds? I found a picture of him sewing in the Army.
And I see his name.
Yeah.
Presley Elvis.
Yeah.
And that is his sewing kit.
Yeah. Army hat with Elvis's signature.
Yeah. Check that out, guys. I mean, does it get any better? I mean, look at that. That's Elvis Presley's Army hat and sign. So we're at 27.
27. And of course, got the movie poster. And I got an autograph from Juliet Prowse up at the top there. It's kind of cool.
Juliet Prowse. That was one of his girls, wasn't it?
Yep. Way up at the top there. Story about her and Elvis and Frank Sinatra. Probably can't repeat on camera.
Yeah, you tell me later after we stop camera. Because I have a good one with Elvis and Anne Margaret.
Oh, I bet.
And I can tell you. From GK.
There's a G.I. Blues hat.
G.I. Blues hat, where?
Right here. Then there's the acetate for G.I. Blues. Here's his Army book, 2nd Division. This is all kind of, I hate to say, I don't want to use the word jumbled, because it's not really jumbled, but it was tough getting it in here. This is Elvis's personal copy of G.I. Blues. Two film reels came from, that was Elvis's.
So this is how Elvis saw G.I. Blues, was from this movie reel.
That was his copy. That was his personal copy.
That was his, so this played at Graceland. I remember him stories, they would, down in the basement, they'd screen some of his movies. Those early years.
Those were sold from by Lisa Marie.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Wow. And then one of the coolest pieces to me is that display of old-looking papers.
Uh-huh.
The little paper is another Elvis autograph.
28.
This is his Army discharge papers.
Okay.
It has all his vital signs, his height, his weight, his age, his birth date, his social, everything. 6 foot tall, got his heart rate, blood pressure, you name it. And the crazy thing is, nobody really wanted to bid on it.
Why?
I don't know. Maybe the condition, but it's like you can read it. You can read it all.
Sergeant Presley, US 53-310-761.
Crazy.
That's unbelievable. I mean, that's all of his information right there.
So now you're coming out of the GI Blues, you're coming out of the Army stuff. Oh, we missed one important thing.
Yeah, what did we miss?
And you probably know this, Trey, being the Elvis expert. You remember what he did, what his job was when he got to Germany?
When he got to the tank. He was like the general. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So he's in Germany.
Right.
But he had to learn how to drive in Germany.
Right.
So that's his driver's manual.
Elvis Presley's driver's manual for Germany.
It's got his, they stamped all his information on it. And he, when he left, he gave it to someone and he autographed it for him. His autograph is right there.
29.
That piece is cool.
Yeah, that's very rare.
Well, there's only one.
There's only one of one, Glenn. I mean, think about it. You see it's folded, Glenn. That means he probably folded it and put it in his pants.
Pocket, yeah,
put his pocket.
Yep.
Probably one of these, you know.
Didn't mean nothing to Elvis.
Means the world to everyone else.
Crazy.
Incredible. Incredible. Yeah, I'll take that one. I'll take that one. That's pretty cool. Whoa, wait. Wait, this is from, what's the Western he did?
Flaming.
Try not to look. Flaming, you said it.
Flaming Star. Well, it was originally named Flaming Lance, as you see on the script. And then it was Black Star.
Black Star.
And then it was Flaming Star.
So, and didn't he sing Black Star?
Yeah, absolutely.
And they had to change it.
And there's the acetate. Got the acetate. Let's see what that has. Has Flaming Star, so it's not a Black Star acetate, it's a Flaming Star acetate, but yeah.
But you see here, it was called Flaming Lance in June of 23rd, and then they changed to the Star when they premiered it.
Yep,
for some reason.
So there's the boots are knockoffs, replicas. There's his wardrobe picture. The pants are the pants he wore in the movie. And of course you got some a timesheet, a picture of him and Barbara Eden in a still shot, and then his timesheet, which basically shows his pay, his weekly pay.
Let's see what Elvis made.
$35.95 a week, or is that a day? I can't tell.
Yeah, $3,595.32. Because he made $28,762.56 that week, right?
Not bad.
So his day rate, because you know actors have day rates, was $3,595. $3,595.32.
Gotta get that.
That's something I needed to know. That's great.
You know, there's information in here I don't even know. I learn stuff when I come to here.
And I'm not cheating. This is like Christmas, like where you don't want to see your presents, you know? Because there's stuff to my right of me. I can just feel it.
Let's see what we got here. Blue Hawaii. These are all acetates from Blue Hawaii. Blue Hawaii is over to our right. You got a little still shot here. You see the crayon marks. I'm going to call it a red crayon. It's kind of orangish red.
Uh-huh.
That's what the newspapers used when they did an advertisement. They'd take a photo like that and then they would
crop it.
Yeah, that's how they cropped it.
That's great.
You got the album. You got the script. We got a lot of scripts here now. So the only script we're missing so far is Loving You. So up to now. That was a puka shell necklace Elvis gave to Dr. Nick when they were filming Blue Hawaii.
So that was Dr. Nick's.
That was Dr. Nick's, yeah. Oh, here's Elvis's personal Blue Hawaii film reel. It's right there. So,
16 millimeter, right?
Yep.
I wonder if they still play.
Was a style back then.
Have you tested it out?
No. You know, everybody keeps telling me I should play these acetates.
Yeah.
No, I don't see that happening. So, this was Elvis's first piano he ever bought.
Oh, yeah, from down off the, because I found that building. I went inside that building. It's down beside the Peabody.
There you go.
Okay, Hauk piano.
And he paid. There's a write-up somewhere. He paid like $50 down, and they set him up on a payment plan. And this was actually one of those self-playing pianos, but had been disabled.
Oh, okay.
Another collector has the receipt, but he doesn't want to sell it. There's a copy of the receipt.
Someone else has that.
You see it's signed by Elvis. Yeah.
Man, that is cool.
That was Elvis's first piano and bench. It's all there. Crazy, huh?
So that was at Graceland.
That was.
Or was it at Audubon?
It was at Audubon Drive House. No, it was at Graceland too. And then it went to a museum in Nashville for quite a while. And I remember correctly, that's who sold it to me. Went to an auction house, but they were the seller. Yeah.
I'm glad you have it now.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching this episode of Globetrotting with Trey. Don't double dribble. Subscribe. It's free. You stay updated with every new video that I upload, which is once every Tuesday, and special ones here and there. Please like this video if you like it. Share it. And until next time, I'll see you down the road. Thanks for watching.